Holy Ghost. Thank you, my son, in the name of God. All the glory unto you, my God. All the glory be unto you, O God. All the glory, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen. Standing before you is Sister Donna, amen. And I'm the woman of God for tonight. I'd like to take this time to appreciate the office of the EOC for programming me, and also the office of the BEC for approving. Amen. I believe that it's by the grace of God that tonight I'm sharing the word here. Amen. It's not that I'm a better preacher or whatever, or whatsoever, but it's because of His grace. Amen.
Amen.
Let's clap hands for Jesus. Tonight, you're going to get our scripture in the book of John 12, verse 23 to 24. That's our first scripture. John 12, verse 23 to 24.
The book of John, chapter 12, verse 23 down to 24. It reads as follows. And Jesus answered them, saying, the hour is come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit.
And then the second scripture is in the book of John, chapter 16, verse 21.
John 16, verse 21. A woman, when she is in travail, hath sorrow, because her hour is come. But as soon as she is delivered of the child, she remembereth no more the anguish, for joy that a man is born into the world.
And then jump to verse 32.
John chapter 2,
verse 32, chapter 16, verse 32.
John 16, 32.
Yes.
Verse 32. Behold, the hour cometh, yea, is now come, that he shall be scattered, every man to his own, and shall leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me.
And then Matthew 26, verse 39.
Matthew 26, verse
39.
Yes, verse 39. And he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt.
Amen. Let's close our eyes as I bless the reading of the word. Glorious Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Holy Ghost, how can they believe, my Father, if they have not heard your word? And how can they hear your word, my God, if the preacher has not preached? My Father, how can the preacher preach if you didn't give him or her a message, my God? I pray for this way, my God, that as I'm going to teach it to your people tonight. In Jesus' name, Lord, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
I don't even know where to start. The title for tonight is the season of manifestation, and then in brackets, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Let's give Jesus a hand of praise. The scripture we have read, the Bible says that, let me start here. Now, there was a feast in Jerusalem, and the people, when they heard that Jesus was coming to the feast, they sang a song, and they went to meet with him, and they were happy for him. And then, but the Pharisees were jealous, and then the Greek also were among the people who were worshiping in the feast. And then the Greek approached Philip, and then they said, "We want to see Jesus." And then Philip went and told Andrew that the Greeks and the Pharisees want to see Jesus. And then Philip also went and told Jesus that, "Jesus, the Greeks want to see you." Immediately after Philip has told Jesus that the Greeks and the Pharisees want to see you, Jesus replied and said, "Surely I'm telling you that the hour has come, and now is the hour, that the Son of Man should be glorified." And then he continued and said that, "Unless the grain fell into the ground and be buried, it cannot come out and produce grain." Yeah. Hallelujah. Then from this I see something. Jesus is saying that, "Surely I'm telling you that the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified." But I'm asking myself a question, that Jesus, what do you mean by that? That the Son of Man is to be glorified. Jesus, we have seen you in the past performing miracles. You've changed water into wine. You have healed the sick. You have cast out the demons. But yet, do you mean that you are not glorified by that? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah.
Because you're saying that now is the hour. And then when you are saying that it was by the time he was going to be crucified, that the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Mm-hmm. Jesus, were you not glorified by then? Was there no glory in whatsoever that you were doing by then? The hour has come. Jesus, you say that the hour is now for the Son of Man to be glorified. manifestation.
Yeah.
In that hour, the suffering will come. And then in the book of Matthew 26, where we have read, the Bible says that Jesus prayed and said, "My Father, if it's possible, may this cup pass by. But not my will of God, but your will." Another preacher was preaching and was saying there is so much inside the cup. And I agree with him. It's like the bread, the crucifixion, the bread, the death, and the resurrection and the crucifixion of Jesus was prophesied in the Old Testament. Meaning that whatever that he was going through, it was part of the package of his destiny. During the season of manifestation, there is a sense that you encounter certain sufferings. You encounter, you know, rejection. You encounter betrayal. Before Jesus, in that hour, before Jesus could be crucified, his very own, one of his disciples, Judas Iscariot, betrayed him. Before you go and manifest, child of God, there is certain sufferings that you're gonna endure. Praise the living God. During the season of manifestation, the very dear people that you trust the most are gonna betray you.
Yeah.
That's the truth. It's part of the package.
Yeah.
It's part and parcel of the destiny.
Amen.
During the season of manifestation, you know, child of God, it's not a mistake for you to be born in that background.
Mm.
It's part and parcel of your destiny.
Amen.
You know, there's a certain anointing that a certain specific individual carries that is very unique from somebody.
Yeah.
Everybody carries a different anointing.
Yeah.
You might be an apostle, you might be an apostle, but there is something unique that you have that he doesn't have. And there is something unique that he has that you don't have. That's how the things of God work. The things that you go through in your life is part and parcel of your destiny. For Jesus to be betrayed, it was prophesied in the Old Testament that he would be sold with 30 pieces of silver. And Judas sold him to the Pharisees, meaning that it was part and parcel of the destiny. People will betray you, but it's part and parcel of the destiny. For you, BT, to well in the position that God has placed you as the chairperson of finance, people will betray you. Someone will move away from you. You'll be left alone. And that's part and parcel of your destiny. Because God does not want to share his glory with anyone. The Bible says that the present suffering that we are suffering cannot be compared with the glory that is going to be revealed within our lives. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
And then during the season of manifestation, there is also rejection. People will reject you. Your dear ones, wonderful people, are going to reject you. Your parents are going to reject you. Because that's the season of manifestation. Before you could manifest, you have to suffer certain pains. You have to go through certain pains, sufferings, rejection, betrayal. In that hour, the Son of Man is to be glorified. And the Son of Man cannot be glorified until the seed falls into the ground and comes out and produces grain. That's when he can be glorified. Jesus said it in John 16:32, where we have read that, "In that hour, all of you will scatter and leave verse. Scatter and leave you alone. It's because they are not designed to be there in your destiny. Rejection will happen in your life. I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You know, I always give the testimony that I grew up without my father. My father is a rich man, but he never took care of us. But during the season of manifestation,